Our big focus is on the touring, the rental touring business, so live music, if you want to say so, includes also corporate trade shows. And I think historically Clay Paky was there maybe even more than 80, more than 70, 80%. Now we try to put the company a bit on several pillars. We strengthened a lot our theatrical portfolio. Also this year, now for Pro Light and Sound, will come more static products under the ADB brand, and also work on more products for installations. Architectural, to be honest, we are almost not represented, unless sometimes our products are used in architectural applications, but it's not a core business of Clay Paky. What makes us different, besides, of course, also, I would say, maybe the Italian touch, the Italian attention to design, to a certain way of doing things, that we really have put a heavy weight of our investments, but also the way how we organize our people and our also get new people on board in innovation. Innovation is, I think, since the company exists, much longer than I'm with the company, but is and was always the backbone and the DNA of the company. We are roughly between something between 6 to 8% of our revenue is R&D investment. So we have really launched a new innovation initiative, developed a totally new innovation platforms from laser engines down to specific noise and thermal management algorithms and so on. The portfolio, a second big topic, we really have on the one hand side cut down the portfolio tremendously, really reduced the portfolio with products that we think were not up to the time anymore, and at the same time have introduced, since 2019 most likely we launched maybe 20 to 30 new products, so really a big product initiative to really be again well represented in different categories and power class as well as technologies in the market. We have really digitized the company. It was a very important point. Internally means we introduced new processes. It's always supported by digital tools, CRM, but also demand planning, forecasting, and so on. And at the same time, also externally, we digitized the company with our Cloud.io system to make service and the handling of our fixtures easier by making the fixtures smart. The whole concept is under smart fixtures, smart processes, and then we combine them all because they're supported by digital technologies. We have changed completely our layout in production. So we have now a so-called Kanban-oriented one-piece flow. Kanban is a methodology out of Japan. And now we are doing the same with our suppliers. So we are not only doing the Kanban pull principle within the internal flow, but also now with our suppliers, that we try to manage everything in a more lean way so that we do not have too much stock but a good reaction time. And then there's even more stuff to mention, so not to forget, for example, our employees. We introduced the Clay Paky way, which with a totally new set of values as well as a new vision and mission, because specifically in the pandemic I really felt it important to tell our people why we are there, why we have a right to be, why we get up every morning, and that we work in the end for a very fascinating market. And this also, this passion, this way of doing things needs to be also supported by the right values. So we introduced this new vision, mission and value program with also concrete measures. For example, we introduced a new learning and development program to educate our people, to increase the competences. We introduced also some new ways of collaborating, bringing people from different departments together. Osram itself, that was IPO'd, so brought to the stock exchange a couple of years ago by the mother company Siemens, got taken over itself by AMS, a semiconductor company. So AMS, I'm not a deep expert of this company because now I'm not with them anymore, but is a company that focuses a lot on the semiconductors and sensors. And they bought Osram, my assumption is specifically for the part that is the LED business, so the semiconductor lighting part of Osram. And so shortly after they bought the company, I don't remember exactly when, AMS Osram, the new company as it is called, announced that they would sell certain parts that are not part of the core business. So in the end, Clay Parkey was one of many businesses. I think in the end they sold 5-6 businesses that were not part of the semiconductor focused strategy, and they sold it over the last years. And Clay Parkey, because of the pandemic, was only the last one to be sold. Yeah. So it was a pure focus on the core business behind this strategy. Manufacturing here in Italy was also one of the reasons why Ari bought us as a company, because they are also an industrial company and they see also some advantages of producing in Italy, because also here labor cost is lower than in Germany, for example, and you have really a good talent pool of engineers and production people. And we always try to keep a good mix between made in Italy and made elsewhere, to balance well and to have usually every really high-end innovative product is produced here, and more the bread and butter products we produce in Far East. So definitely, yes, we will continue. We are working constantly on new products. I think our new mother company, Ari, is known very much to be really one of the market leaders in the film and TV business. Yeah, so film production, cinestyle as they call it, but also TV and studio and show business. And I think they can bring us, amongst others, for sure, two things. Number one is they open maybe a new market for us where we are not so much present, and where it seems that moving heads come also now more and more into play, like the film production business. And on the other hand, we work, of course, on some technological synergies. Yeah? Ari is known for a very good quality of light, color control, which is maybe something that we can benefit from. Then maybe we are known for motor control and electronics and also optics. And so I think we can exchange on several areas, and our engineers are already working together on some projects to really exchange good ideas. Yeah. The nice thing about Ari is that they are not making now a hard integration and simply reorganize everything. They keep us as an own business unit, really quite independent, and they try to stimulate know-how exchange instead of only organizational synergies. Yeah, because they acknowledge that we are a quite different business and are totally complementary to their business. And this is, I think, a very good approach, and we are working really well on this, and we started already exchanging, and I can see that very beneficial. For me, innovation is not only about the product or the process, but it's also how we basically create our products, and how in the end those products have an impact on the market and on our environment. There's an official ISO certification norm that we did, which basically measures your CO2 footprint as a company. Yeah? And we did this for the first time for the year 21. Started last year, and we have really a very senior person, our former CTO that went into retirement, is taking care of this project. It's called CP Green. And this means that we have really, as the first entertainment lighting company, an official carbon footprint, like a P&L for your carbon emissions, and also a carbon management with the goal to reduce and become a carbon neutral company by 2030. And you know, if you want to become, whatever you need to do and you need to optimize, you need to measure. Just to give you some examples, we optimized our heating. When we buy new cars, we always evaluate electric cars. We work on a solar project on the roof that could substantially reduce our energy consumption from the grid. We work on packaging, plastic avoidance topics, and. This is really a serious project that we do. Maybe also with one day a commercial impact, but really because we think this is important to do as a company.